Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips. Color grading your photos in Photoshop using the curves and hue saturation adjustments is doable, but sometimes it's hard to see what's happening. So I made for you this reference chart that you can import into your photos, and it will let you see exactly how your adjustment layers are affecting the tones and colors in your photo. The reference charts are intended for people who already have some experience color grading their photos, and it's not really made for beginners. So I'm not going to be going into too much detail about how to use the tone curves, how to use the hue saturation adjustments. But if this is something that might interest you, then keep watching and you'll see how it works. After downloading, you'll find three image files. Start by dragging and dropping the two Photoshop reference chart images into your document. You can scale it to any size you like, and then press enter when you're done. Make sure that the top reference chart is positioned as your top layer. You can then place your adjustment layers in between the two reference chart layers. For most color grading effects, you really only need two layers, a curves and hue saturation adjustment layer. You can add these layers, by the way, from the adjustments panel. If you don't see this, you can find it by going to Window, Adjustments. Click on this button here to add the hue saturation adjustment layer. And then click on this one to add the curves adjustment layer. So here's how it works. The upper tone chart here is for your curves adjustment layer. The bottom chart here is for your hue and saturation adjustment layer. Start with the tone curves. In the Properties panel, click on the Targeted Adjustment tool here. This tool lets you click anywhere in your image to add a point on your tone curve. But instead of clicking on your image, you'll be clicking on the chart and dragging up or down to adjust it. For example, if you want to lift the blacks, just drag upwards on the black part of this chart. You want to start with the 5-zone chart, which will give you the blacks, shadows, midtones, highlights, and whites. If you need more precision, then you can switch to a 9-zone chart. The gradient on the bottom of the chart is there only so that you can be sure that your tones are smooth and gradual. To show you a quick example, I'm just going to make some tonal adjustments like this. Next, I'm going to switch to red, green, and blue channels to tint the different tonal areas like this. By the way, if you want to learn more about this, click on this video here to learn about the tone chart technique. It's a great way to learn and understand how the tone curve works. Okay, so I'm done, and next we're going to move to the hue saturation adjustment layer. Now with this adjustment, you can use the target adjustment tool here, but I actually find that it's easier and more precise to just use the sliders. There are four rows in the chart. Basically, when you're adjusting the hue, look at the hue chart here. When you're adjusting the saturation, look at the saturation chart. Same thing with the lightness. This chart lets you see exactly what color adjustments you're making. The rainbow gradient up here is to ensure that your results are smooth and gradual. Now when you're making color adjustments such as shifting the hues, it's very hard to notice the difference. So that's why it's important to look at the color chart while you're making the adjustments. When you're done, you can delete the two layers with the chart. And that's how you use the tone and color chart in Photoshop. By the way, if you want to export this as a color lookup table or LUT, to use another software such as Adobe Premiere or Adobe Media Encoder, you can just go to File, Export, Color Lookup Tables. LUTs are a great way to get the same consistent look in other software if they support it. It's not supported in Lightroom, by the way. To end the tutorial, here are some examples of color grading effects made with this technique. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. I apologize for rushing through it and not going into too much detail. But I need to get this video done and uploading before I sleep because I have really slow internet, so it probably takes about 3-4 hours for it to upload. Anyways, if you want to learn more about this chart, then check out my video on how to use this chart in Lightroom. It's pretty much the same thing, but I go into more detail. And as an example, I use one of my favorite photographers, Masashi Wakui. He takes amazing photos and his post-processing style is very unique. So in that video, I show you how I replicated one of his looks. Not exactly the same thing, but very similar to it, using the same chart. It's a great way to learn more about color grading and how to decode other people's effects. So if you're interested in that, then click on the video on the right to watch it. Anyways, it is 4:20 a.m. right now, so I'm ready to sleep. I hope you guys have an awesome day. Let me know what you think in the comments. And if you subscribe to my channel, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.